Zen Qigong is about body awareness and relaxation. And relaxation is best described by kindness, mindfulness and peace, calmness, you know. Because that's the parasympathicus of the autonomous nervous system. And that's something we have to train. But these are basics. You know, kindness, mindfulness and peace, sleep, relaxation, nutrition and meditation. And body awareness, of course. You know, when you are very, very fresh with all this stuff, you think body awareness, what he's talking about? You know it, that's right. You know, body awareness, I'm here. You know, my body is here, I can feel it, everything is fine. So relaxation, what he's talking about? Have a beer, that's a relaxant. No, but that's a little bit rough. But you have to start somewhere, you know. These are the basics, you know, which we are dealing with, which we are cultivating. And when you are coming to a kind, mindful and calm equilibrium, it's very healthy, of course, because the stress is cutting off the rebuilding of your body. Even digesting is slowing down, and you can feel it when you are coming to this equilibrium state. Nothing is in between your inner smile. It's evolving by itself. You don't have to force anything. It's a stupid smile from within, you know. And that's something to cultivate, really. Because it's always a good sign for yourself. I'm on the right path, you know. And when you cultivate it, you can pause within the day and ask yourself, am I kind with myself, with everybody? And am I calm? And am I aware? You know, these topics are also very huge, but it's like a tripod, you know, it's always bringing yourself back to an equilibrium, and the reward is your inner smile. It's very, very good. Now the physical basics. It's standing and walking. Basic standing position. You should have 1 foot length apart between your parallel feet. Just 1 foot of your own foot. Then the knees, slightly bent knees. You know, you can bring the knees even backwards, that you are really standing in your bones. That's something you have to realign. Always coming out of this totally straightened legs, always a little bent knees, legs. No? There are different schools, lower or more up, but never these cranked bone thing. Then you can feel it. Take your pointer fingers to the lower hip bone, can feel your hip bone, hopefully, and the upper hip bone, and then you can do a whip, can come to the front with your lower hip, play around with it. Even this might take years, you know. So that the arc of your legs is coming to the position, lower hip to the front of your hip, and up to the middle, your back is straightened by itself. Of course, if you are able, without strain, to breathe into your belly, it might help even more. Then a little gap below your armpits, a little bit outwards with your elbows, front of your hands, slightly to the front, upsides of your hands, a little bit sideways even. Loose fingers, and for the upper body and your head position, take your collarbone just a quarter or a half inch to the front. Let your shoulders are a little bit opening and your head is erecting by itself. You can feel it. When you can breathe freely in the upper region, you know, then all these muscles, ligaments and bones are a little bit opened. And in this position, find the most relaxed position. Always, always body scan, basic. There is a narrow stand, this normal stand, broad stand, and two horse stands, but this is the basic, everything is building up from it, you know. And also this standing around and finding always with a never-ending body scan, finding the most relaxed way is already the most basic of all Qigong forms. Because that's body awareness. How do I feel now? So when you're taking your time for yourself, you might find uncomfortable things, you know, in your mind and in your body. But that's okay. Take care of it. With a physician, with a psychotherapeut, you know, with professionals. It's okay, because these are main themes in your life, and it's very good to take very slow and in a wise manner take care of it, no? Because that's leading to more healthy and easy living. That's one. Basic standing position, and then the mental thing is the mind, which might be in the way to your bodily feelings because it's producing all kinds of stories. And that's very similar to the normal meditation, you know. And a very complex to explain and a little bit complex to learn is the basic form of walking. Feel comfortable in one leg. Everything from the basic standing is coming up here, you know, slightly bent, evenly distributed, now in one leg, one foot, distributed weight, lower hip to the front, slightly erected back, and so forth. The other foot is on the toes and your front balls, foot balls. The heel is up in the height of your roof of your standing legs foot. And then the direction of your hip and your foot is maybe around 20 degrees tilted to your moving direction, always. Then you can take the loose leg and with parallel soles to the earth, try to find out the area you can describe with your foot without moving too much and without going out of the direction of your hip. Always, when your weight is in your standing leg, the hip should also point in the direction of your standing leg's foot. It's very important not to rotate your knee with weight. Always, when you like to rotate your knee, take out the weight. It's very important. And then it's a very narrow step. It's more sideways, not to the front. The heel should be in the height of your foot tip of the standing leg without weight. No? It's also very important. And that's one snapshot. No? The beginning, heel up, feeling comfortable in the standing leg. This step, narrow but not broad, a broad step, yes, without weight, and then distributing the weight to the new standing leg while rotating the hip. That's one step, one snapshot. All these single snapshots are very good to relax within, no? From the beginning. Heel up, relax. Step without weight, can look down, broad, yes. Then distributing the weight to the left leg in this case, relax. Keep your spine erected, gaze to the imaginary horizon, feel your lower hip to the front. And now we will tilt this new standing leg foot a little bit outwards, this 20 degrees to our moving direction. And therefore we have to take out our way coming in the middle with our weight. So the hip is also in the middle, directed. Now you can open a little bit in your hip bone, in your hip joint without weight. My weight is now completely in the former standing leg, and now coming with the weight totally to your left new standing leg, relax completely to the ground. And after several years, you don't have to pull your back leg. You can relax in this position and relax even more to the ground. Relax the right side in this circumstance and let the leg come by itself. A little bit to the front. Now I'm in the left leg with my weight. One snapshot. This broad step without weight. Hip in this direction. Coming with your weight to the right, lower hip to the front, snapshot, coming to the middle, snapshot, open in the hip joint, 20 degrees, coming totally to the new standing leg, to the right leg now. Relax and relax even more. That's it. That's the basic walking. And that's very important. Now all the forms, carrying the chi for instance, which will be the first real Qigong movement form. It's carrying, giving up with your weight in the new leg, taking to the middle your weight, open up, carrying your weight, giving up to the front and collecting and so forth. But that's for the next session, you know. So the basic walking, basic standing, and basic attitude towards all this Zen Qigong is very important. Because the forms are nearly unimportant, you know. Most important is your own attitude to learning. We are learning, and practicing. You know, the way is our goal. That's Lao Tzu. And that's not without meaning. So, be always kind, mindful and calm with yourself. Every single second is new. You are learning from your mistakes. Be relaxed. Be easy. And that's really something which is easing up your own life. And that's a side effect. That's the introduction. I hope you can take away something for yourself, you know. That's my basic attitude to all this streaming, YouTube, and even on the meadow, because I think I'm more like an old master. I'm not so much like a teacher, you know. I'm not finished with my own way. No, I'm not without fail. And I think that's authentic. No, that's at least it's my way to bring you what I have learned. And I know some of you like it that way, a very few of you, because that's not with action. No, because action is distraction leading to stress and so forth. And we are on the way to relaxation, kindness, and mindfulness. Yes, and kindness. I think kindness is main topic for this year. For many decades, of course, but I think that's something I have to promote a little bit more. For myself also, yes. And I don't have to talk about love, you know, because love is something different. Unconditional love is really something we all have to cultivate. It's not coming from it by itself. And kindness is the little sister, little brother of love, you know? But we need it.